Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my people. What's going on? Today, I want to talk to you about something. Something where I was growing up and I was thinking to myself, 30 grand, 40 grand, 50 grand a year is decent. And I'm not trying to put anyone down. Don't get me wrong. But this video, it's about how you can make 50 grand a month. And yeah, I know you're already thinking like, how is that even possible? And trust me, when I was growing up and when I was at university, getting my first job, my second job, that thought wasn't even a thought. And this is what I really want to talk to you about. Sometimes it's not actually about the number itself. It's actually about the path. If you need to make £50,000 a month, what you need to understand is how much you need to sell something, how much you need to make from three or four side hustles to make £50,000 a month. Is it as easy as I say it is? No, of course it's not. But if you have a business where you're selling a product for £3,000 or £4,000, like for example, my recruitment company, where if we get a placement could be anywhere from £4,000 to £5,000, £6,000, £7,000, even more sometimes. And for example, if we make three of those placements, that's £15,000 nearly, for example, on average, £15,000 a month from three placements in recruitment. Now, for the ones that want to do social media marketing, if you have 10 clients and you're charging them £1,000 a month, for anyone that does social media marketing and you're good at what you do and you have a good clientele base, £10,000. You can make that sort of money. If you're in the teens, if you're in the 20s, if you're even older, don't ever think to yourself that you can only make £2,000 or £3,000 a month. A lot of the times it's in the mind. It's the mindset. If you put your mind to achieving a certain amount of money, i.e. being £50,000 a month, so what's that? £600,000 a year. That sounds crazy. But really think about this. Do you think the people who now make £1 million a year or are billionaires got to that number because they thought we're gonna make £30,000 a year? Or £50,000 a year, or £100,000. No, no, of course not. What they thought to themselves is, you know what? We're just gonna put that hustle in. We're gonna put that hard work in. We're gonna just work like crazy and the money will come. And trust me, that is huge. What you wanna do is work hard. Find a car. What I mean by that is find a business that has the possibility of scaling up, where you can hire employees, where you can hire people, grow the business, whether that's a product, whether that's something you want to take to market, whether that's a service that you want to start. Inshallah, don't worry. The business ideas will come. Subscribe to the channel, listen, like the video, but these videos will come in terms of when I talk about business ideas that you guys could start. Obviously, if you have more money, then yeah, of course, you can start a business which may have a bigger return, because as we say in business, money makes money, right? So look, £1,000. If you have £1,000, to make it into £2,000 is not that hard. But to make £1,000 into £100,000 is difficult. And so what you need to start thinking is, right, £50,000 a month is my target. Currently, I'm making £2,000 a month. I need to start something which maybe needs to be a passive income. If you start a passive income, i.e. a blog, maybe a YouTube channel, maybe something on social media, maybe a service that you could provide to the people, £500 a month, £1,000 a month. Now you're making £3,000 a month. We're very far away from that £50,000 a month, but that should still always be your target. Take that £1,000 away, put it into stocks. Right, now you're getting some money, maybe say 10% on stocks. That's very slow. Of course, you might see some losses. You might see some positive results. Let's say in return, you're looking at 10%. Over the last 15, 20 years, you know, the stock market has gone up in 10%. And again, only halal stocks, none of that haram stuff. That's a drag. Say you're making 10% on your money. You're saving more money. And now you're like, you know what? That's passive. I've set that up. I've made my money. Now you can maybe start looking at a product, for example. And you're thinking to yourself actively, you know what? I could definitely take a product to market. You come up with a product. It's £10. Or let's say your product itself is £20 and your profit margin on that, for example, is 50%. It costs you £10 and £10 is, you know, your markup on that. That's a high markup, of course, but I'm just keeping the numbers simple. What you need to do is do the maths. If you sell that product 100 times, we're looking at £1,000. Now, it's not easy and it never will be, but this is where you have to start thinking big. For example, if you can take that one product to market and say you're advertising it yourself, say it's on your own website, you've got the Facebook ads running, and that product itself is selling 100 times on a £10 profit, it's making you £1,000 a month. Right, now you need to start looking at how else can I push this product out? Well, you look at other influencers, get other influencers to shout you out. Maybe you can go to, for example, depending on what the product is, right? You can go to other supermarkets, but say, for example, it's an Islamic product, right? You can take that product to websites where they're selling Islamic products and ask them to sell your product in return for a commission. You know, you might give it to them cheaper because they offer a bunch, etc., etc. Now, the point being is you have to think big. It's never easy to think small, and it's never easy to just think to yourself, you know what? If I sell this 10 times, I'll make £300 and that'll be enough. The point being is, as soon as you start thinking bigger, as soon as you start thinking, I can achieve something big and I can actually make so much money, then your mind and your process and your plan starts going towards that. Now, you might be like, okay, fine. I've sold this product in the UK. Now I need to go international. I need to go to America. I need to go to Canada. I need to go to Pakistan, wherever it is. So all of a sudden, this product where you were selling 100 times by yourself, you could easily, potentially, inshallah, with time, sell it 1,000 times. And then the money starts adding up. And that's the point. If you're making £10,000 then, for example, from selling a product, then what it will come down to is making that £10,000 make more money. And it's a slow procedure. Now, this could also be applied to a service where you're charging a certain amount of money to someone for your service. Now, let's say, for example, it's £100. You're providing a service, whether that's something on training, whether that's something in, you know, it could be recruitment, marketing, whatever you're good at, right? You're providing a service to the people. Now, you're doing it by yourself, you're limited to £100, let's say, a day, right? But if you now can hire someone, if you can grow your team, if you can teach people to teach others, if you can scale up, all of a sudden now, if you have 10 people making £100 a day, and in return you say to them, well, it's my setup, I will teach you, etc., etc., but I want £50 in return, from 10 people you could be making £50. And that's the point. You want to think big. So if you're making like £50 a day from someone, and trust me, this method does apply, it does work. That's actually what a business is. You train people up, you ask people to work for you, you invest in people, you employ people, you say to them, I will pay you £1,800 a month, £2,000 a month, £2,500 a month. And in return, what is expected is they bring more value than what they're getting paid. In essence, that is what a business is. If I'm a business owner and I have 100 people working for me, I will pay those 100 people an amount that I feel is enough for them, but I will get a return at least double, if not triple, to what I'm paying them as a salary. And that's how you have to start thinking when you want to think big. Now, is £50,000 a month big? No, it's not. It's take steps. £10,000, then £20,000, then maybe £30,000, then £40,000, £50,000. You're making £50,000 a month, and then you start thinking to yourself, you know what? I think I can achieve more. Should you get lost in it though? No. Don't make your life about the money. Remember always that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that will give you the rizq, will give you the money, and it is Allah that will put the barakah in your money. So remember that always and stay close to your religion. Because if you stay close to your religion, you'll be surprised in the sort of things when you're pulling a few strings and something happens and you're like, whoa, where did that come from? Listen, you know already where that came from. So hold your salah. Hold your salah very close to you, and inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for you. But what I will say is this: a lot of the time it's the mindset. I know you guys are like, yeah, but you can't just say it's the mindset, we need the ideas, etc. I know. But how many of you guys, genuine question, I used to make this mistake. I wanted to start a business, but I never ever went out and researched businesses. Like, imagine, I would never go on the internet and be like, 100 businesses to start, 20 businesses to start in 2021, ideas. I would never do that, because I'm not saying you necessarily need to mimic the idea that you find on YouTube or on Google, but what you need to do is open up your mind, because you might see an idea and you're like, oh, you know what? They're doing that. I can put a little twist to it with my own way. Does that make sense? So open your mind up. Open your mind up in thinking, you know what? I don't want to be middle class anymore. I can achieve more. I can make more money. But put that plan in, and inshallah, it will become easy for you as long as you work hard. And that's the other thing. Like right now, if you're working Monday to Friday and you're working a job and you're like, I don't have any time. Trust me, man, you have time. And you can wake up an hour earlier, 2 hours earlier. You can, you know, in the evenings, put in 1 or 2 hours. You can on the weekends put in like 4 hours. So work this out. If you put in 2 hours every day in the morning or in the evening, that's 10 hours Monday to Friday. And then if you put in 4 hours on a Saturday and 4 hours on Sunday, that's 18 hours. 18 hours in a business, in a side hustle, in the beginning is a very good amount where you can start getting the ball rolling. Maybe you can start making like 100, 200 pound a month or 300 pound a month or 400 pound a month. But it's about making the time and it's about it adding up. So many times, come on, like we know, we just sit there like watching random stuff on YouTube or Instagram, scrolling up or down. That's a drag. Don't waste that time. Wake up earlier, make that time useful, and make use of the time where, inshallah, that time itself, not only does it have barakah in it, but it is the time where you are most awake. And if you're even planning your business or planning the things that you need to do, that's going to benefit you. And imagine if in the morning you like make a couple of calls, right? If your business is where you need to speak to companies and clients and stuff like that, trust me, from someone who does that on a daily basis, if you call a client at 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock in the morning, like the managers, directors and the big boys be at work at 7, 8 in the morning. You might not have to start work till like 8:30. So if you get up at 6:30, plan your calls and start calling at like 7 o'clock and call until 8:30, that's like an hour and a half you could easily call. So it's not about, I don't have the time, it's about making the time. If you really want it, have the desire. Like push yourself, like be like, I really want to do this and then go for it. And inshallah, then make the most of the time and don't necessarily feel like you're just wasting your time. Because if you're just being productive for 2 hours every day for 5 days, that's gonna make a huge difference. So look, business ideas are not easy to come by, I know. I know it's not that easy to start a business, and not am I saying that by any means, but I am saying this. If you start your own company, if you start your own business, you are able to practice your religion with ease. You are able to help the Muslims and if inshallah you can earn more money. And that's a lot of the times, man, what it's about. Like, I want you guys to be in a situation where you can help the Muslimin. Does that make sense? I want you to be able to pray with your chest out, and I want you to be the guys hiring people, even hiring Muslims and saying, you know what, I want to empower you. I want to make you be able to pray Salah whenever you want. In fact, the brother or sister says, oh, you know what, I want to pray. And you're there like, Subhanallah. I wanted to be in the situation where someone comes to me and says, I want to pray. And I say to them, Tafadlan, continue, go on, go pray. Of course, no problem. In fact, you say, let's pray in Jama'at. And you pray in Jama'at. That's the most beautiful experience you can have. As someone who owns a company, I assure you, praying in congregation with my people, the people in my workplace, is the best feeling, man. Where I know that I used to find it so hard to pray Salah when I was working at recruitment companies, and I'd be like, oh man, I don't want to tell my manager or my director I need to pray. Now, alhamdulillah, we pray with our chest out. It is about earning more wealth and earning more money and having that path to getting that success. But I want you to understand, it's not just about that. You need to stick to your Islam as well. And you need to pray Salah in congregation and employ people and make it easier for other people and get them to a situation where they are also feeling empowered, where they can also make a lot of money for themselves and inshallah benefit the Muslimin as well. And look, that's all for me today. I appreciate your time. You guys show me hella support. So I can't lie, man, I appreciate it so much. Again, if you haven't already, subscribe up to the channel. If you haven't already, like the video. If you haven't already, support me and keep me in your da'as. Inshallah, I can benefit more and more people. I'll try to make these videos more and more. I'm trying to make three a week now. You know what I mean? We're up in that game. Like I said, you know, if you feel like you don't have enough time, make time. And I'm here like 12 o'clock in the night recording for you guys. So if you guys can show some love, I'd really appreciate it. But again, Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.